Hello, so I'm at Herne Hill. Thameslink and Herne Hill station is just behind me. A few days ago, GTR and Thameslink got in touch to say, during the current situation, Jeff, would you like to come and see what we're doing to clean our trains and our stations? And I said, yes, where's it happening? And they said, St Albans and Bedford. I said, can I get a Thameslink train there? And they went, of course you can. So I did. So I've got the train at the invite, thanks as always, of GTR and Thameslink to see some cleaning take place. And then, after we're done here, we're going to go and see some trains being cleaned. I want to conduct an interview, but I'm going to step out the station so that I can remove my face covering. And over here, there's a gentleman called Alan Howe, who's basically the contracts manager. He's in charge of all the cleaning staff and all the cleaning teams here on Thameslink. I hear you're doing more cleaning than ever before.
We certainly are. We've deployed teams across the entire network, doing enhanced cleans of our staff and stations across the entire southern and northern network. Once every 21 days, we apply a product called Zuno, which, by using electrostatics, adheres to surfaces better than other products, giving it a latent efficacy of around 30 days. We reapply the product every 21 days to make sure that we're optimising its performance.
Right, are we going back inside?
Okay.
So, mask on? Mask on.
So currently the guys are using dry steam, which is superheated steam to prevent aerosolization. It's vacuumed back into the system and that stops any bacteria being spread by the cleaning process.
So every single part of the station is being cleaned. So this area here by the ticket hall, the outer ticket hall, onto the platforms, into the waiting rooms. Is that going to take all day, several hours?
So this lady is doing a manual application of a 24-hour viricide onto all surfaces, which we use as the pre-clean to applying the Zuno to ensure that we've got the best possible outcome for the Zuno application.
It's a little bit Ghostbusters with the backpack on, isn't it? But what's in the backpack?
So the backpack contains the Zuno chemical, which is being applied in a mist. We use an electrostatic wand, which makes the chemical adhere better to the surface and for longer.
I've switched to my iPhone. You're freezing your phone. There's a gentleman here called Darren. He's got an ATP swab machine. I can't pronounce what ATP stands for, so it's on screen now. But basically, how clean is a surface? So we're going to do an amazing comparison. So you want to swab my camera surface?
Yes, sure.
Do it right now.
No, don't do the lens.
Oh, not the lens. Mm. Yeah?
Yeah, do a bit of swabbing on there. And then what, you insert that into the machine?
Yeah, you do it for around about 10 seconds before.
You do just here.
Right. Takes 15 seconds to read.
That's all right.
Seven? Yes,
I did just use hand sanitizer,
that's why. Oh, so my hand sanitized hands have been all over my camera. Yes. And they've cleaned. Okay. so weirdly I should have not sanitized my hands. So as the cleaning continues here at St Albans, we also realised that earlier, the reason why I'm clean and my camera's clean is because when they were misting the stairs, I actually got caught in some of the mist. So the mist has sprayed over me and we're all clean, which is a good thing. But we've got to go catch a train and go to Bedford. We're back on the train heading north, this left Flitwick, heading for Bedford, because it's not just the stations that are getting a deep clean, the trains are as well. So we're heading for Bedford carriage sidings to check out the cleaning that's going on there.
Yeah,
So the high vis is on, the safety shoes are on. We're going to walk across some tracks. We're going to go to one of the trains. They've actually closed off some of the roads so that we can walk out here safely and board one of the trains.
Bonus fact is that there's two parts to the depot sidings here. There's a bit where only 12 car trains can fit, and then the bit where we're in where only 8 car trains can fit. There's a lady called Janine who is, there's buckets and spray. You look like you're about to do some serious cleaning.
It's a three-step process, Jeff. The first one where we're using an interior cleaner, which has got a biological agent in it, an active enzyme that kills any bacteria that may be on the surfaces. Then we'll sanitize the surface with a hard surface sanitizer. And then when that product is dry, we will then apply the Zuno to all the high contact points on the train, so it gives our customers the reassurance that anything that they're likely to come into contact with whilst they're travelling on our services have been treated with this viral side.
And also another fact which I liked, you were telling me, so traditionally most of your cleaning is done at night. So how many staff do you have here during the day, and how many do you have working here overnight?
So during the day I have 5 cleaners because I have a limited number of trains actually coming in out of service, but overnight it can be anything up to 35-40 people because the majority of the fleet is not running around overnight. We're cleaning with the viral side every high contact point on the train. So that will include the grab handles for the customers, these little handles on the top of the seats, the trinket tables and the fixed tables in first class, and particularly any door buttons or vestibule bars that passengers are going to come into contact with.
A lot of people forget that you are a 24-hour railway, aren't you?
Absolutely, yes. So what happens at night is if there are trains that are not going into a cleaning depot overnight, then we will have our partners from Churchill's attend to those units on the platforms in the stations themselves, so at Bedford and places like that, where they'll see a turnaround clean where they're literally getting rid of all the nasty things that people leave behind.
Like what? No, don't answer that. I don't want to know.
Okay.
I don't want to know. I do want to know. Tell me off camera what nasty things people leave behind, all right?
So you can see from my day that GTR and Thameslink are sanitising their surfaces on their trains and at their stations. And if I were travelling on their surfaces right now, that would make me feel much happier about travelling safely. But we'll get to that in a minute. Because I also asked about staff, and I spoke to the lovely Steve Lamon, who's GTR's Director of Engineering, and he showed me an app which they have on their phone. And what that does is that it enables drivers or train operations, when they book on to start their shift, they can literally type in the unit number and see when that train and the cab and all the controls that they have to touch and use every day was last cleaned. And that gives them great peace of mind as well. And that's a brilliant thing that they're doing for the staff. And that brings us to where we are today. Until now, it had been essential travel only. But the messaging from the DfT and the Rail Delivery Group is changing, and it's now let's travel safely this summer, which you may have already seen communicated this week. And that is what the government want you to do: travel safely back on all buses and trains and public transport. So I hope everything you've seen in today's video gives you the confidence to go ahead and do that. So thanks to Alan and Darren and Janine and Steve and to GTR Thameslink for having me along today and showing me what they're doing to make travel safer for all of us.